There are three major medical questions regarding circumcision. First, do uncircumcised newborns have a greater risk of urinary tract infections? Second, do uncircumcised men have a greater risk of sexually transmitted disease, especially HIV, in adulthood? And finally, do uncircumcised men have a greater risk for cancer of the penis?
To make it feel.
Dr. Denniston says the answer to all three questions is no.
I have never seen in my entire career a subject in medicine that is more fraught with misinformation and disinformation than this area of scientific research.
But Dr. Wiswell says the benefits of circumcision are clear.
People who have looked at the data carefully, and that's both physicians and some non-physicians, have all come to the same conclusion. Hey, the medical evidence is there.
Given these diametrically opposing viewpoints on the medical benefits of circumcision, no wonder parents and even most physicians are confused about statistics and studies. And after listening to both sides, so were we. So 2020 recruited an outside expert to review the scientific studies and offer a dispassionate assessment. Dr. Alexander Walker is chair of the Department of Epidemiology at the Harvard School of Public Health. Every year, he reviews hundreds of published medical studies on all kinds of subjects. At our request, he evaluated more than a dozen studies selected by Drs. Wiswell and Denniston to support their opposing viewpoints. His conclusion:
overall, the medical literature comes down pretty strongly and pretty consistently on the side of a net benefit for routine circumcision in newborns. A lot of the data that we're talking about has really evolved in the last 10 or 15 years. If you look at the current data, the view that there's really, you know, no medical benefit is an outdated view.
However, Dr. Walker also makes it clear that the benefits of circumcision are statistically quite small.
So on a scale of 1 to 10, if you had to take a stab at a number, and we won't hold you to it for the rest of your life.
I'd take a 1.
A 1. Very small, but very real in your judgment.
That's right.
The debate about the medical benefits of circumcision has also put the nation's most respected children's health organization on the hot seat. The American Academy of Pediatrics will soon update its public position on circumcision after many months of internal discussion. But even after the Academy comes out with its new statement, most parents will still rely on the advice of their own physicians.
Dr. Miller says many doctors try too hard to influence parents' decision about circumcisions, even though, medically speaking, either choice is reasonable.
The risk of not being circumcised, while there are some medical risks to that, are not that compelling that they make a major, major difference in the child's well-being as they're growing up.
However, recently the advocates against circumcision have raised a whole new issue, one they hope will help persuade parents not to circumcise their sons. They say circumcision means less sexual pleasure later in life. Anti-circumcision activist Billy Ray Boyd says infant boys lose more than foreskin when they are circumcised. They also lose sexual sensation. Author of the book Circumcision Exposed, he claims that the foreskin is a highly erogenous zone.
So I'm going to mark here the circumcision line, what's cut off. Now, in an adult man, adult male, when he has an erection, if he's not circumcised, the head of the penis pushes out from its sheath, its protective covering. And you can see all the skin from here to here is all missing, and half of that is highly sexual, highly erogenous tissue that contributes greatly to the sex act. And it contains, I think, 240 feet of nerves. It contains over 1,000 nerve endings. So if you think, for every man who's circumcised, if you think that sex is good now, think how much better it could be with all of that extra highly erogenous tissue.
But the experts we contacted say while it is true that the foreskin has a lot of nerve endings, they say men have plenty of other nerve endings in the rest of the penis to more than compensate.
Does that make any sense to you?
No, there's plenty of opportunity for sexual pleasure even with the removal of the foreskin.
Dr. Richard Kogan, a psychiatrist and sex therapist who has counseled more than 3,000 men in his practice in the Human Sexuality Program of New York Presbyterian Hospital, here is teaching a class of professionals. Dr. Kogan says none of his patients has ever linked circumcision to loss of sexual sensation, and that includes men who have been circumcised in adulthood and who could compare pre- and post-surgery sensation.
I only know what I've seen clinically, and it is a non-issue clinically. It's a non-issue. There's so many issues that come up in my office. This is not one of them.
But while circumcision may be a non-issue for the experts, it is a very big issue for the public, parents especially. An issue that is likely to provoke continuing and passionate debate well into the next millennium.
Well, one piece of guidance may help. In 1989, the American Academy of Pediatrics said that there were medical benefits of circumcision, and in just a few weeks, on March 1st, they're expected to update their public position for the first time in 10 years. And this is very important because most pediatricians follow the Academy's recommendation. But at this point, we don't know what the new recommendations will be. Well, when we come back, an important development in an explosive 2020 hidden camera investigation.